construction, you have a shout box or have an annotation box on the right side. Have some targeted questions over there. Customized questionnaires would be, again, they'll work on the same concept as annotations, but you need customized questionnaires for people who want to give you inputs. Not suggestions, inputs. Suggestions are something which will tell you, okay, this can go further. You can go take this approach. Those are not suggestions. Those are not inputs. What we want is inputs. Well, I've learned that while teaching, this misconception just takes people off track. That is an input. For that, you need to direct their thinking by asking them very, very specific questions. Can you tell us about one misconception that you have had? Can you tell us about one objection that people have when relating it to their real life models? When you ask such specific questions, inputs build up. And then the author, he has two things. First of all, he has resources which he can think about and then talk and then write. The second is that he's receiving inputs on his work. That is the biggest reward that an author can get. Huh. Next thing is, we have talked about existing knowledge. The next thing is checklists. I suggest that people go out there and see the importance of checklists in developing quality work. You can give people instructions about a variety of things. How do you ensure that they will carry out each step out there as possible? Checklists, I'll just say one thing about them. If you have a very well-made checklist of vital, essential and desirable things to do, you have a system in place and you do not need to educate people about everything. You do not need to have seminars about them. You just give them a checklist, they'll go through it and they'll do things. So, three things about a checklist are that you need to have made something like, you need to have divided the steps into vital, essential and desirable. Vital is your bare bone structure. If I have a ball pen, then the vital thing about it is the refill and the writing system. Essential is what makes it useful. I won't use a refill without the body. And desirable things are what makes it, well, desirable. You can add bells and whistles to the ball pen. You can make it more exclusive. You can add a silver gripper type grip to it. So, desirable things, wiki books would be more useful when we get to the desirable stage. But first, we need to complete the essential. And this thing about prototyping it faster, I have described a lot of processes, and these would be useful only if we have a system to start them. Now, one thing I've come across recently is a website named Wicked Start. Alright, and it takes a person, it takes an entrepreneur who wants to write a business plan through 10 or 15 different tracks, and he has to fill in information about the questions that are asked there. And if he is stuck somewhere, he can go through the resources, he can watch a video about it. Now, why is he answering these questions? He's answering this question because he's making a plan before starting a business. We need to take that approach, we need to borrow that approach from them and give it to people who want to start a textbook. What will your textbook be about? How is it going to be different from textbooks that exist? If you're writing on physics, how is it different from Zamansky's textbook? How is it different from Hilde Rizik? How is it different from H.C. Verma's textbook? Or what gap are you filling in? We need to ask specific questions. And again, having such a form, having such a 10-step form is a very big advantage. If right now we have a lot of textbooks that are completed, this goes to show that there are people motivated enough who will work through without any reward. And what if you have a 10-step approach which asks you a question? Okay, just need 2 minutes. Yeah, what if you have a 10-step questionnaire answering which you get to know about your own project clearly, and you have everything in place. You don't need to go to 3 or 4 different places. You don't need to go to a community help desk. You don't need to go to a guideline page. Everything is right there in one page. That is enough motivation. So I've completed prototyping faster. I've completed, well, I haven't got to crowdsourcing yet, but I'll just give you a very short introduction on everything. Crowdsourcing is, well, you define tasks and then you let people do it for you. And Wikipedia is all about it. Now if you want to use a crowdsourcing approach on Wikibooks now, then you have to make a distinction between knowledge-based tasks. You have to make a distinction between insight-based tasks and stuff that requires, well, mechanical work. So you need to have tasks defined. You need to have them defined as an object. You need to be able to send those tasks across RSS feeds, across checklists, across software. And well, that is how you will be able to pull in other contributors. And that is about crowdsourcing. Well, it goes into a lot of details. I have a report uploaded. It's a 13-page report, and you can read all about it on the proposal page. Outcome-based thinking, well, again, I'll move faster. Yeah, so outcome-based thinking is this. First of all, everything. If you have listed down all the tasks, now define an outcome and cross-link every task with an outcome. You know, if I want to see this section completed, go through all the tasks that are listed out and copy and paste them here. And this will allow you to complete one part of a textbook very fast. Now this is stuff for productive discussions. This is actually Getting Things Done, Workflow by David Allen. You can look it up. There's a whole industry around it. It is actually a productivity system. Now this is for making discussions more productive. Whatever goes through, have a system in place through which you can process inputs on top pages. It starts there. What is it? Is it actionable? Is it not actionable? If it is not actionable, either delete it or file it as reference. If it is actionable, is it one action task, or do you need a whole project around it? And do it. That is how you classify the inputs of 1,000 different people from chaos into actionables. So that is about getting things done. What about persuasive design? Well, again, this is a very broad topic. People will or will not do something because they either have or do not have the motivation, they have or do not have the ability, or they do not have a well-placed trigger. Well, if you have a like button, you click it, and you click it instinctively. Now, Facebook doesn't ask you, Facebook doesn't make a community and say, well, across the content that was posted in the last one day, watch what do you find better. They do not hold discussions. We have triggers. If I like it, I immediately click on the like button. So there's a whole process around it. How do you go around designing a persuasive system? Again, you can find this on the proposal page. There's a very interesting story around it. I'll just finish it up in 10 seconds. B.J. Fogg is a professor at Stanford University. He has this psychology and capitalology lab. And one day he noticed an app that had around 10 users. One week later, it had 10 million users on Facebook. And then he went on and started a course in Stanford on the psychology of Facebook. And then came across a lot of inputs that Wikipedia can use. Wikipedia and MediaWiki can use themselves. Outcome-based thinking, the last two points, that one point, do review, make it better. That is common sense. We have been told about it, learning from mistakes, right from when we could have been conscious. But the thing is, it's not documented. When you start making it as a formal process, when you have done something, when you have identified the problems, and then you identify what you can make it better, the mistakes of now become common senses of 3 years later, and you want to make it fast enough. So I have defined a very, very broad amount of, I've given a lot of details. I don't think I'd be able to do justice even if I were given a lot more time. The wisest thing to do is go on to the Meta Wikimedia page, Accelerating Wikibooks, and go to the report. I'll update the report with sections, I'll update the presentation. I suggest that if anyone is interested in Wikibooks, then please discuss that topic here. And I end this with one statement that I really liked from Jimmy Wales yesterday. There are a lot of changes that we can make. There are three broad categories of those changes. One of them is changing the software to make things better. But if you want to change the software first, ask for it. They won't know. We have to ask for it. And we can't, and we have to discuss, we have to pilot test, and then we have to give them results, and then convince them to make a very radical change to the software. Remember, Wikipedia started in 2001. MediaWiki was, that was the time when we paid 55 rupees for an internet connection on dial-up. And times have changed radically after that. We don't use computers as a primary interface for going to internet. Times have changed, generations have changed, our own usage has changed. We don't need to go to a top page to give post a message. I want my own dashboard from where I can post a message to someone, and then that message spreads around. That is how we want to communicate. And for that, we need to ask first. So please go to the proposal page and do your due diligence, please. Thank you.
Thank you, Dharav. I'm sorry that in my role as moderator, I have to play the villain. But you can make out from this boy, he's just bubbling with ideas. He wants to tell us things. So we'll request you to make sure that you follow up on your promise and put all the links and other things on that page. And also, if anyone else is interested in touch with you, please provide full information on the various suggestions that you give regarding them. Thanks a lot. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll now be followed by two short presentations